loved what it
was.
Wow.
So,
yeah.
So now I recollect that the baby was teaching me. Yes, so next time we will work out together. And this thing you make for your best time of the day, to make a nice structure for your for the people who train. Now you make a structure for our training.
Yeah.
What is good for both of us, we will train.
Of course.
So you're on record now, you have to do it.
No, that,
I'll put it back on record that you didn't know.
That I'm very happy to do. I mean, she's, I was this is so much of my passion that I should train people for free. Until she came and she's like, listen,
you need
to know your worth and you need to...
That's very
what
good.
Is your karma?
No, that's very
good.
Yeah.
You should train.
And you need to start, you need to do it the right way.
Yeah.
Right?
So
you should. And that's your karma.
Yeah.
That's your sentence. Your deed that you must do it. But I want to treat you like a buddy.
No.
No,
no,
I'm
no, so,
not that I'm going on the
door.
I'll tell you what I was coming to. So with you, I'm going to train. I'm actually going to choose a body part you design it, and I'm going to compete with you. So we, which I know you'll win, but we'll see who can do more reps at a particular weight. Okay. So as you know, we were talking earlier, the mind is very important in the gym. I think it's stronger. But the point is, my mind is very competitive. So I love, for people who are really fit and strong, I love to feel that I can lift as much, if not.
Yeah.
So I'm going to call you for that money.
Done. But what is the date? Just the date.
29th September. Libra. You want to get to Zodiac?
No.
Then just numerology.
No. Numerology.
11 is 2, right? Yeah.
2. You're highly spiritual.
And
intuitive.
I would like to believe I'm not, but I guess I am.
Normally, the spiritual space, you do get intuitive. But yes, I think this has been a wonderful conversation and spirituality and fitness and food. I think we will never end.
We can talk on and on. These are three favorite topics.
Nice.
Fitness, food and spirituality. Food means as a complementary thing to fitness.
Yes.
And spirituality as an umbrella to everything in life.
Exactly.
So that topic can go on forever.
And let's see for sure how I think your videos. Just want to touch upon how your transition actually happened, because a lot of people, a lot of youngsters are struggling with addictions and alcohol or smoking or smoking up, whatever it is. How did you just literally drop it? It just went out of your life. And do add in what I said to you when you wanted to leave it.
So, I used to drink and then I stopped drinking because I was like, I don't feel like drinking anymore. I'll still go out with my friends and everything, but I don't want to stop. I want to stop drinking.
This is when your spiritual journey started.
Just when it had started. So I stopped drinking, and then I started just going out, and then I stopped doing that because we used to go out. Everyone is talking normally. Then I'm not drinking. I'm having water. You're having a beer. One beer, we're still making conversation. Two beers, we're kind of making conversation. Third, you don't understand my jokes, I don't get your humor. And then I slowly started slipping out. So that stopped. And that finally stopped one day. I still remember this. I was having a drink with my brother.
So
at
give
this
story
bar.
Of how we were not married at that time. So he used to go party wherever. I never
saw him. I'll say that. So I was having a drink with my brother and I looked at the side. And these two girls came from the bathroom. And the place was only such that it was dark. And the bathroom was lit up and music was there, and when they came out, they were like giggling and laughing really loud. I told my brother, the pool. He's like, shut the fuck up, what are you drinking? I said, nah, the pool. I swear, that was the last day I went to. Because after I got into the spiritual practice, and because it was that new, it was very intense. So even though we used to go out at night, I used to come back home, message her, and then we used to sit and do the sadhana together at the same time. She in her house, me in my house. It reached a point where I could not handle loud music. I could not handle people brushing me. I couldn't handle crowds. So going to a bar, like even if now I'm much, you know, now it's, now the transition has happened and now it's kind of become
you can manage it.
But at that time, even if someone brushed against me, I move away. So that happened, and I don't know, sir. If I should tell youngsters anything, then it would just be, this is something you don't have to do. This is something if you want to do, then you do. You cannot force yourself to be spiritual. You cannot force yourself to give up alcohol, smoking, drinking.
It is in your good interest.
It is in your good interest to limit your alcohol, to limit your smoke, eventually stop smoking. It is in your good interest. And I'm a person saying this who's done everything on the face of this earth. So you can let your imagination run wild.
I'll second that, but I've done nothing in the world. I've never touched a cigarette. I've never touched a drop of alcohol, but I say the same.
I've done everything. So you know that, and you will say, oh, saw chuhe khake billi haj ko chali. Ha, saw chuhe khali. Abhi billi ko haj pe jana hai. But you can't force someone
but
to take that path. And
you share this.
So I used to have one cigarette, which was at the end of the day, after I finished my dinner, with a glass of half a glass of thumbs up or something, and just one cigarette, because I felt like I needed that. So then I told her, I said, I want to quit this one also. Why am I having this one? It doesn't make any sense. She's like, you don't try to quit it. Just keep doing your practice as you are. Eventually, it will leave you. You would not want to do it. And I swear to you, I was standing in the balcony of my house after, and I was smoking it. Halfway through it, the taste changed. You know, everyone will be familiar with it when you're sick and you try to smoke because you want to, and you've got that weird taste. It was the same taste. And I'm like, I'm not liking the taste anymore. It's been 9 years, I haven't touched it after. It was just like that. It was not cold turkey or anything, but it just happened. So trust me, if it can happen to a person like me, it can happen to anybody. But again, this is something that you would want for yourself.
You didn't bring your system into alignment.
No nicotine patches, no self-hypnosis. None of that stuff will work unless and until you want to stop. And this is for probably anything in life. Unless and until you don't want it, no one has that much magic over you that they can force you to either believe something or do something.
But it is not even about you wanting it. The moment you bring your system into some form of alignment, anything which is not beneficial for your system, it drops off. Naturally.
But I think what will be interesting for Rayman is that how you, let's forget the spiritual aspect, but drinking, intoxication, smoking, I think you're so much into fitness. Absorbing these habits or staying away from these things, how it might have progressed your energy, your fitness, your form, your physique. That's also something that you can follow. Forget the spiritual aspect. Do it for yourself, do it for your body, do it for your
When I was drinking and smoking and everything, I was still very young. I was still 27, 28. So you're still young at that time. And at that time, if you're training hard enough and you're eating whatever, I still had a six-pack. I mean, you've seen me. I was still fit at that time. I wasn't probably as big. I was probably 65 kgs or something. But I was still ripped and strong and fit. But I don't know. Of course,
you're bigger now.
Yeah. But
and ripped. So
but I do believe that 10 years after, and I'm 38 now, and I still feel that how I am today, if I continued along the path which I was at 28, I would have been nowhere close to physically or mentally who I am today. So again, I'm just glad to be. It's been a long journey. There's been ups and downs. There's always been that mental struggle, but you have to be strong. And I tell you what, that feeling when you defeat yourself from not wanting to do something, that willpower, that high is very different than anything else. When you want to do something and your mind, you know your mind takes over and says no, that moment of, and it's again, it's not you versus you. You are your best friend. You are the only friend you have. But that feeling of stopping yourself from doing something that you compulsively always done.
You going through whatever your life has brought you, and no wonder you worship Krishna, because Krishna's life was crazy, crazy amount of hardship. I think you would have
thought. Yeah. Are you now? Yes.
So the whole idea, how do you maintain your equanimity of mind? Going through, it's not that nothing is happening in the mind, hell would be breaking. But look at when you turn to inner wisdom. Now that is this. It can either kill you, or with the grace, it can nudge you in the right direction. Whatever is happening is literally a soul decides, and this is the amount of karma I'm going to take on in this antiquity for this. And that is how it actually.
Now let's come back to raw fitness. I appreciate it. I met him as Deepesh a long time ago, and he came in talking about the importance of fitness, which he was an expert now, not good at traveling, much more passionate about job making. He was good. But I have seen him now after many years. And from Deepesh, it's Shivo, which is. There's a song in Adi Shankaracharya, Mano Buddhi Ahankara, and it's Shivoham Shivoham. Again, whatever we've been talking. So now somebody who's so much in fitness and with such an amazing physique, being so much into spirituality, where you actually re-christen yourself from the page to Shivoham. Now let's talk about your fitness routine. Tell us that, and then you can talk about Shivoham. Now you stay silent.
If I start talking about Shiva, I'll probably start crying. So, I don't know what I honestly like. I tried to. My brother asked me this when the transition was happening. He's like, "Can you explain to me what it is that you're going through? What is it that you're feeling?" I said, "I cannot explain to you why I feel like crying. I can't explain to you why it is so overwhelming."
Yeah.
It is, I don't know, it's an amazing feeling. It's a beautiful feeling. Someone who experiences it can feel it, but it's something that you just cannot describe.
Right.
It's like people are like, you're feeling happy and you're crying at the same time. And it's more than happy, it's not even happy. It's a very...
It's euphoric.
It's like, I'm complete. In that moment, you don't want anything, you don't wish for anything. In that moment, it's just like you are absolutely complete.
Well said.
So,
and you feel the same when you're working on it?
No. No, I mean, you can't compare the two.
I can't. I just want to, because I think whoever looks at you will say, oh my god, he's at the gym and he must be like.
No, but I do. For me, my workout is. I keep telling people, it is not, I get, so, and I will say this very openly, when I'm in a gym, in any gym, and I see people behaving not gym-like, my blood boils. It's a space which I respect. It's a space which is very sacred to me. It is something which I take very seriously and fun at the same time, as long as it's related to fitness. But when I see people fooling around and not taking exercise seriously, you can call me a Hitler or whatever it is, but I've thrown people out of the gym.
Ratsik Guna, and it's required. That's why we say Ratsik Guna is required. So if you don't instill discipline in the gym, people can't work out and they can't progress.
Yeah.
So you need Ratsi Guna to discipline or to say what you're asking those people and be in order.
Otherwise,
I'm here.
I have literally thrown people out of the gym. I have been to other gyms which are not mine and shouted at people and shouted at trainers in front of the client saying, what the hell is this?
you're here to work out, and you're talking about where did you party last night. I said, there's a cafe, there's a waiting room outside.
They don't understand. When you're working out, there has to be a gap between two sets. If you extend a gap from an ideal 1 minute to 10, 12 minutes,
no, you're lost. No, forget the gap. Nowadays, there's no gap. Nowadays, people are... Hey, kal kya kiya? Acha, maine wo bhi apne ye kha. Listen, I don't care. That is your time. Probably that is when you feel relaxed. Not a problem. Great. Please do what makes you happy. But respect the space and respect the people that are around. I'm sorry, but that is just like I've got Bolera on one side, very happy, very smiling, and I've got Bhairav and Rudra on the other side. So it's.
That's the angry room.
That's
right. people have seen me angry, so yeah, I love exercising.
So when you wear a ganji, when you're feeling
happy, you can see both.
People are misbehaving. Put it to one side and show me that.
It just comes out any which way.
So for me, it's exercise is always play. Like if you see me training, You'll feel I'm doing something very intense. Like right now, I'm a lot into calisthenics and gymnastics, which is what kids love to do. Swing on a bar, swing on rings, do handstands, roll over. That is what I'm doing right now.
Yeah.
But again, that I take very seriously. So for me, exercising, and probably that is also a reason why God's grace, I'm recognized in that field, is because It's not only about me making gyms and franchises and making money. Yes, it's about that. But it is something which has been my passion and will always remain my passion. It will never change. So, fitness and exercising is probably...
Please share, what is your most favorite time of the day, apart from your working out time? It's when he's making his workouts for his clients.
Really?
So two times. Of course,
you want to design a workout.
Yeah. So when I'm making workouts for the challenge or for the clients and everyone, and that part of the day, I look towards the evening. So I used to be a mad party person. I've of course seen you party at the same places wherever I've gone. So 3 nights a week, 4 nights a week, coming home at 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock, alcohol, I mean everything. And now we are in a place where in the last 8 years we haven't stepped. We don't go out at night for any dinners, social events, nothing. Unless it is like an award function or something that's different. But so that part of the night where I finished everything and I come to the bed and I just put my feet up and sit.
And switch on
Netflix.
That's your favorite.
That is probably the most... I'm a kind of person where I need to feel if I'm putting my feet up on the bed, it needs to be worth it. And for that, I need to have worked my ass off, and then I feel okay. I've done something, and I deserve to put my feet up and switch on Netflix for half an hour and do something. So even when I was training, Mr. Amir Khan, the days when we used to miss a workout because of work or whatever, and then days when we used to train, I used to be like, sir, it feels like my day is complete. Because we did what we were meant to do. So for me, it's like I said, I think probably the Rajasic good is very high because I
need it.
I need to move and I need to work and I need to make sure that the day was spent perfectly in what it was. And of course, there are days like Sunday, I will, even though if I wake up at 7, I will not get out of bed till 10. No, because it's Sunday, you need to have that tamasic good and lie in bed and do nothing the whole day. Just relax because you need it.
Yeah.
Work 6 days a week.
No,
not
only
a problem.
You need it. People get required.
No, I'm just saying, people, you need to relax as well.
You cannot just be working. You need to chill out.
How do you train? Would you ideally like to train?
So right now, my routine is for 2 hours, and in 2 hours, I do at least half an hour to 45 minutes of stretching and mobility and stuff, because when you're doing gymnastics and calisthenics, you really need to be flexible enough to do all that stuff to make sure you don't get injured.
So I do that, and then I do my hour and a half of whatever drills and fun stuff that I need to do. And that again is something which people will want, because once you're addicted to that feeling, then there's no feeling left. And you want to defeat yourself in that negative phase every single time. I think it's just a repetitive thing that.
Lovely. Well put. Well understood.
Thank you both of you for such a wonderful, multi-dimensional conversation, the 360 degree view.
The editor's going to have a mind-blowing idea.